Thank you.
The acting finance minister, who assumed office last month, has emerged from his self-imposed honeymoon with a fresh determination to pass the finance bill, which is crucial to unlocking funding for various government programs. The bill to be tabled next week was withdrawn from parliament last year by former finance minister Uhuru Kenyatta, protesting attempts by MPs to introduce amendments seeking to cap interest rates at 4% above the prevailing central bank rates.
I think the people who have borrowed even most are the members of parliament themselves. So in addition to saying that they are taking care of the public, yeah, they also have a vested interest.
The prevailing political undertones aside, Githae has admitted that the high interest rates have slowed down private sector credit and reduced investment, a factor that is likely to have a long-term effect on the economy.
If we continue this way, our middle class is in danger, and therefore we must find ways of protecting the middle class, because that is the sector that has really borrowed.
Meanwhile, Central Bank Governor Professor Njuguna Ndung'u has assured the country that there is adequate reserves to guarantee the stability of the shilling. The governor has, however, conceded that despite the gains made so far in stabilizing the shilling, the government may have to review its projections after it emerged that the cost of power may go up again following a drop of water levels at the hydropower generation dams.
Weather conditions praise havoc in terms of domestic food prices and also energy costs. So essentially, we are cautious in terms of what we can promise.
Githae and Ndung'u are speaking on the sidelines of a one-day forum for central bank governors on inflation and its effects on regional economies. The forum was organized by the African Development Bank, ADB. Henry Githaiga, Citizen Business.